YouTubers, I'm here today for you guys to show you the things I've picked up and beautiful new eyeshadow palettes. I've been picking up a few things here, there and everywhere, and I start with skincare. And the first thing is the number 7 Beautiful Skin Hydration Mask for dry, very dry skin. And it looks like that. I thought it looks really interesting, and it says treat your skin to a little luxury with this delicate soft hydration mask to leave your skin feeling beautifully soft and smooth. Hopefully I now will get into doing masks more regularly, and I'm really intrigued by the number 7 brand at the moment because I've been trying the Protect and Perfect Intense Serum, which I really really like. So I've picked up now that they had an offer going on 2 more. Comes in a container like this, and number 7 has got different range skincare for different age groups. So mine is the Intense, I think it's age group 35 to 40 or 45, something like that, and this works perfectly. The only thing with it is it goes so quickly. The first one I've purchased, I've had that for about 1.5 months and I'm nearly through. And that it is 30 milliliters in there. Or maybe it's because my skin just really craves for it. It's like my skin asks me to put on more and more and more. I try to stick with 2 to 3 pumps though. And I use it only in the mornings. So yeah, I'm glad to have 2 more of my serum, which I really love, for a good price. From the same line, the Protect and Perfect Intense line from number 7, I also picked up a new eye cream. I'm always on the hunt for the next best thing in eye cream, and since I've been really impressed with that serum, I thought, let's try the eye cream from the same line. Visibly improves deep lines and wrinkles for your younger looking skin. Let's see. I will keep you posted how I like it. The next thing I've picked up is from Indeed Laboratories, and this is a brand I'm just getting into now, and they had a sample set with 3 sample sizes for about £12 or so, and it's the Nano Blur, the Snoxin and the Hydralone cream in it. And I was really curious to try that brand out because, and there's another suggestion for you, I found a girl on YouTube because I was searching for new brands you can get in the UK, and she actually reminds me so much of Lisa Eldridge, the way she talks, and she's just beautiful. I love watching her, and it's Skin Deep Beauty Vlog. I will link her channel down below. Go and check her out. Say hi from me to her. I haven't got too much experience with this brand at all, but she loves the Hydralurone cream, and I'm really curious about the whole brand, so this was perfect for me to pick up. And I'm interested to see how the Hydralurone cream works for me. These are the 3 kind of samples. As you can see, they are very, very tiny, but it will be enough product for me to try them out and see which one I like. So here's the Snoxin cream. And the claims on this cream is quite interesting. It's 4 times better than $500 serums. This is quite a big claim. Let's see. That's the first one. The second one is the Nano Blur, which I have heard about before. And it says, look up to 10 years younger in 40 seconds. Wow, another big claim on this one. And the last one is the Hydralurone. And it says Intense Hyaluronic Acid Moisture Boosting Serum. So yeah, really excited, and thanks so much to Skin Deep Beauty Vlogger, she's got a blog by the way also, for showing this cream and recommending it. I'm dying to try it out. Okay, let's move on to makeup. As you might know, I have been on the hunt for a perfect kind of under eye concealer for a while now. I was interested actually in the Giorgio Armani Maestro and the NARS Creamy Concealer. So thank you to all of you who gave me great suggestions of which one to pick up. And I must say, number one suggestion out of all the concealers was definitely the NARS Creamy Concealer, and I so wanted to pick it up. So I went to the counter and I swatched the Vanilla and the shade Custard, and it seemed like that the shade Custard for under the eyes, it doesn't give me too much of a brightening effect, because I do like brighter kind of concealers or makeup under my eyes. Then I went to the Giorgio Armani counter to swatch both of them next to each other, these concealers, But the thing that really put me off is when I picked the Maestro concealer up and I undid the lid, it was really kind of messy. I mean, it is a high-end product and it is pricey. I'd probably waste a lot of product, so I wasn't sure. Then I thought, well, no, that's it. I go back, I'm gonna get the NARS. So I went to the NARS counter again and I said, give me the creamy concealer in the shade Vanilla. So he went to check and guess what? They were out. Anyhow, one counter's loss is not the counter's gain. I didn't think that I was gonna pick up a concealer at that point, but then I went to the Charlotte Tilbury counter and I was so glad that I didn't pick up the NARS, the creamy concealer, because I looked at the retoucher and I thought that's it, I have to pick that up. It says it's an ultra covering traceless finish concealer and treat stick to disguise imperfection, pores and uneven skin tone. Enriched with black tea extract to smooth and moisture. And I've tried it twice and I'm wearing it today. I really, really like it. So let me show you what it looks like. I have got the shade number one, Fair. And obviously for under the eyes, I really wanted to get a light one. I like the packaging. It looks glam. And it comes in one of these brush applicators, like the Touche Eclat. I don't know if you can see that, but the brush hairs are not really all that in place. But that's not a big problem for me. Put it where I need it, blend it out a little bit with the brush, and then just press it in with my fingers. That's what it says on the packaging also, and it works well. I really, really like it so far. On longevity, I can't say too much about it yet, because last time I wore it, I didn't pay attention to that, but I will test it out for a good couple of weeks and I will definitely do a review then. And since I was at the Charlotte Tilbury counter, I also got myself a foundation sample and I'm wearing it today. Looks like that. And they didn't write the shade number on the bottom. Quick tip, if you live in London and you go to Selfridges asking for a foundation sample, take a container with you, because they never have containers. So I went over to Giorgio Armani to get a container. That's the first time I've put it on, and it is very, very lightweight. It has a little bit of like a face cream scent to it, but the scent definitely doesn't linger. The shade I got is a little bit more on the yellow side, which I prefer to pink. I need to test that out a little bit, and I will definitely do a review and demo video with this foundation. So a video is coming up on the foundation and on the concealer. Maybe I do a two-in-one review with these two products. That probably would be interesting. I think I'm talking and rambling a lot today, so I try to move a little bit quicker now. I picked up another eyeshadow, which is Handwritten. In my Big Mac haul, I wasn't able to pick it up because it was out of stock, but I got it now. And I really, really love that eyeshadow. Matte brown with a little bit of red undertone in it, and it's pigmented, it's soft, it's probably not the best swatch. Let me do this again. And I love this eyeshadow for the outer V, to darken up the outer V, blend it into the crease. Yeah, this one was missing in my palette and I'm so glad to have it now. Talking about MAC, I got two more palettes. Let me just tell you a big, big thank you to Michelle Makeup MOC. She has been so, so helpful and a blessing, because I got some stuff from her which she sent to me that I can't pick up here in the UK. And I also asked her to throw in two MAC palettes. They are just the regular ones. Thank you so, so much, Michelle. I link her channel down below. She's such a beautiful lady. I'm obsessed with her, and she loves and knows her stuff, honestly, so go and check her out. You really need to start watching Michelle if you don't already. And the other two things she picked up for me, the Laura Mercier The Artist palette. You have no idea how much I wanted this palette and how happy I am that I have it in my hands finally. And oh, the packaging is really, really nice. And it's not that big, it's really kind of neat and small. And it's got that faux leather. It's just really, really nice packaging, and it's got a magnet here, and this is what the eyeshadows look like. There they are, beautiful eyeshadows. Oh, there's lots of palettes coming out again for the holiday season. I really wanted to narrow myself down to get only three. Well, only, that's enough already anyhow. And I definitely will do a tutorial with this beautiful palette. It's just amazing. It's different to all the other makeup palettes I have so far, because it's got more kind of purpley shades in it, especially in the top row, or now it's on the bottom. You can see here all these kind of really nice purpley shades in it, and on the top you've got the more neutral colors, so a very different one, and I'm totally over the moon to have it. I'm not sure if this one will come out in the UK. I know it's limited edition. So anyhow, I have it now and it's my precious. And another palette or brand I can't get over here in Europe is Marc Jacobs. And look at that. It comes in a pouch like that. It's a really nice weight to it. And the packaging is gorgeous. Obviously, I got the neutral one, and this is the number 206 Lolita. And when you open it, you have a protecting plastic on it, saying Marc Jacobs on it, and there is the palette. Look at this. Even though I have so many neutral eyeshadows, honestly, I had to have that bad palette. Because if I ever was to design my own palette, this would be it. Three matte shades, a brow bone shade, a blending shade, and for the outer V and liner, and some light shimmery shades. It's perfect. Let me just swatch the matte shades for you. Look at that. Oh, amazing. Yes. I like the pigmentation. This one here in the middle has got glitter in it. Let's see how the glitter wears on the eyes, or if it falls down. Clearly you can see that. And these are the four lighter shimmery shades. All these swatches are without the primer, and here's the MAC handwritten, ignore that for now. And this is the palette. Here are the three matte shades, and here are the four shimmery shades. And I had to have that palette because I know I'm gonna get so much use out of it. This palette has got my name written all over it, so I'm so excited. I'm just in palette heaven right now. Let me just swatch the Laura Mercier palette, or a few shades. And the one I have to swatch, which I'm really interested in, is the African Violet. Look at that. Oh! Oh, wow. So, so pretty. Look at that purple. It's the purple. The deep purple at the end here. And I've never tried Laura Mercier eyeshadow, so this was the perfect opportunity to try out the Laura Mercier eyeshadows. So let's swatch Bamboo. It's this one. Let's do Primrose. It's this one. Oh yes, they are saturated in pigmentation. Thank you so, so much, Michelle. And oh, she sent me a gorgeous card also with a cat in the front. And she wrote some kind words in it. This means so, so much to me. And also trying out these new things, or just by thinking of me, it means so much to me. Michelle, I love you. Thank you. And the last palette I've picked up, you've seen my Instagram picture already if you follow me on Instagram, is the Clarins palette. And it's the Clarins The Essential palette. Let me just show you what it looks like. It looks like that. The packaging is like the Urban Decay Naked palette, so it's cardboard, but it's a little bit harder cardboard. It's not flimsy or anything. The colors they chosen is not the most modern, but I guess it's the Clarins colors. And they have a strap wrapped around the palette. It's not magnetic. And when you open it up, it looks like that. The shades don't have names, they have numbers on it. And it comes with that plastic cover. You have here a look you can recreate with the numbers. And on the other side also, just for some ideas. It's always neat to have that. And it comes with a brush. It's a double-ended brush. And I think it's not bad, actually. I can work with that brush. Normally you don't get good brushes with palettes, but this one looks okay. It's soft and looks okay. And let me just show you closer what the eyeshadows look like. And you are surely thinking, oh, I know this palette reminds me of something. And yes, it does. It is very similar to the Naked palette, which I have here also. These are the palettes next to each other. Same as with the Naked palette, this palette has got two matte shades in it. Oh, just back to the packaging. You can take the eyeshadows out and you have a kind of case for, I don't know, brushes to put in when you're traveling or whatever you would like to do with this box. Yeah, it is similar but not quite. And this is the look I'm wearing today with this palette. The matte shades are really good. I really do like this blending shade. Let me just show you. It's a very, very nice one and I'm wearing this in the crease today. It's a little bit more of a reddish brown. Very nicely pigmented. The peachy shade, I don't know, I don't like using that for the brow bone. It is nice and pigmented and it's very, yeah, you can't see that because it's my skin tone. And for me, I'm wearing that on my brow bone today. I can wear that all over the lid for a neutral look, but for the brow bone, I wish they would have put in a little bit of a lighter shade. In terms of fallout, I always do my eye makeup before my foundation, so I can't really judge, but they are not as powdery as for, say, Lorac eyeshadows or Too Faced eyeshadows. I'm wearing this one on my lid today. A very nice kind of taupey one. And this reddish brown in my outer V blended in, and I blended it up with this one and this one in my inner tear duct. So that's what I'm wearing on my eyes today, and it gives really nice definition, especially the darker shades are really nice and pigmented. Look at that. The lighter eyeshadows are not as nice as the darker ones. The darker ones are really, really nice. I've been requested to a review of this palette and I definitely will do that. And I probably will throw in a little bit of a makeup tutorial also to show you how these eyeshadows apply. Another neutral palette. I just love my neutrals. I get always excited about neutral eyeshadows. Don't get me started. So that's all the things I've picked up recently. It's getting dark outside and I say goodbye for now. Thank you so much for watching. Lots of love from Cornelia.